reasons. But stronger than expected January jobs reports signaling that the labor market in the U.S. is ripe for a liftoff. We got that Friday. But today we got the JOLTS report. Shows the churn of job openings and hirings, labor turnover. What this number does, and it's highly watched, it's one of Janet Yellen's favorite pieces of econo data. What it does is it shows you how many jobs are open for every unemployed worker, and it flashed a neon green light today. Green all the way. I'm talking about the December job openings and labor turnover survey. JOLTS report showing that there are now more than 5 million job openings in America. I asked the man in charge of the labor market, U.S. Labor Secretary Thomas Perez, about what that number actually meant when he first saw it this time around.
Confidence. Another indicia of an economy where the fundamentals are strong. And when I look at 1.7 job seekers for every job opening, when you compare that to roughly 7 job seekers during the recession, I see confidence. When I look at the fact that 2.7 million people are voluntarily quitting their job, that means that they have confidence they can get a better job. Confidence. That's what that equates to. And an economy where we have the wind at our back.
We finally started to see wages increase in January. That to me is not a trend yet. It's 1 month. Why have we not seen this great number translate to better wages? We still see stagnation.
Well, there's a few dimensions to that, Liz. First of all, it's important to know that the jobs that have been created over the last 2 years as the recovery has picked up steam, something like 8.5% of those jobs have been low-wage jobs. So we're creating good jobs, especially in the last 2 years. At the same time, I totally agree with what you said. 1 month does not make a trend, and we need to translate the productivity increases into shared prosperity. And one of the best ways to do that is to have a continuing tight economy. Tight labor markets equal leverage for job seekers. That 1.7 figure I gave you and your listeners, you know, in the end of the Clinton administration, that figure was closer to 1. And so we got room for improvement there.
A lot of the open jobs, simply they cannot find people who are skilled appropriately. Please tell our viewers what areas we're talking about. Is this in nuclear energy or highly skilled type of jobs?
Oh, there are job opportunities for people who have a PhD, and there are opportunities for people who are a high school plus. I mean, you look at the area of IT and cybersecurity. Mm-hmm. I have spoken to CEOs and other business leaders who are looking for people in those areas, and you don't need a college degree to begin your career pathway in IT, in the health professions, in the allied health professions, in cyber. These are great jobs, and that's why, you know, I've said to you before, Liz, we're Match.com. You know, we match, we connect job seekers who want to punch their ticket to the middle class with employers who want to grow their business. And the secret sauce of success is often the upskilling that we provide through the investments that we make in our workforce system.
And the timing, though, when it comes to this oil situation is not quality. It's not great. We see right now, currently, oil companies, oil services guys, they are slashing jobs at the moment because the price of oil has come down. Do you worry that the oil industry is the next housing construction crash?
Yeah, we monitor the situation closely in places like Louisiana, North Dakota, Texas, and elsewhere. At the same time, it's important to recognize that for consumers across this country, they have somewhere between $600 and $900 in their pockets, depending on how much gasoline they're purchasing, and that's a big raise for people.
Yeah, so you see,
and what we
see oil, low oil prices as a net positive, correct?
Well, hey, if I'm someone who's struggling to make ends meet right now and I've got $600 more in my pocket, that's good for me. And what happens is people spend that. They're not putting it in an offshore bank account. And so restaurants have more customers. Businesses who sell things have more customers. And that, you know, two-thirds roughly of GDP growth is consumption. And people, when they have more money, can consume more things. And so that certainly helps the economy. So we're watching the situation in energy markets, but at the same time, you know, the folks I talk to, they like $2.10 a gallon.
Because it's saving them money. Our thanks to Labor Secretary Tom Perez, and perhaps they're spending some of that money on stocks right now.